Hey friends, have you ever wondered how the world moves around you while sitting still? Imagine this. You're relaxing on a mountainside, taking in the breathtaking view. Below you, vehicles are winding their way along the roads beneath the mountain. But here's a thought. What if it's not the cars that are moving, but the mountain itself sliding backward? How can you tell the difference? This intriguing scenario raises an important question. How do we truly know whether something is moving or stationary? To unravel this mystery, we need to explore the concept of a reference point. In this video, we'll explore how a reference point helps us understand motion. Here, you see a rabbit happily hopping away from a tree. The tree stands still and the rabbit moves farther and farther away. But how do we know the rabbit is actually in motion? This is where the concept of a reference point comes into play. A reference point is a place or object used for comparison to determine if something is in motion. Objects that are considered stationary, like trees, buildings, or even mountains, serve as effective reference points because they don't move relative to the Earth's surface. In our scene, the tree acts as our reference point. As the rabbit hops, its position changes continuously relative to the tree. Because the rabbit's location is shifting relative to this stationary object, we can tell that it's in motion. Let's explore another relatable example. Imagine you're comfortably seated inside a train gliding through a dense forest. As you gaze out the window, you might notice the trees outside seem to be moving backward, slipping away in the opposite direction. But wait, are these trees traveling backward? Of course not. They're firmly rooted in the ground. Why then do they appear to be in motion? This illusion arises because you're in a moving train, using either yourself or the train as your reference point. As the train moves forward, your position changes relative to the stationary trees, creating the illusion that they are moving backward. In reality, it's the train, and you with it, that's in motion. Next time you're traveling in a train or any moving vehicle, take a moment to observe this phenomenon. We've explored how reference points help us understand motion. Let's test your understanding with a quick question. You are watching birds soar across the sky while sitting on a park bench. What is your reference point when observing the bird's motion? Got your answer? Let's see if we're on the same page. When you are seated on that bench and watching the birds fly, the bench itself acts as your reference point. It's stationary, anchored in one spot in the park, which allows you to observe the motion of the birds relative to your position. This fixed point, the bench, helps you gauge the direction and speed of the birds as they move through the air. Understanding this helps clarify why the birds might seem to be moving faster or slower, depending on their direction and your perspective. Does that make sense? Let me know in the comments below if you have other examples or questions about reference points.